wet and wonderful afternoon in College Park. The number one Terps take it 11-10 over the Rutgers Scarlet Knights. Bad back and all. Bruce is dancing. Mason, Bruce. Bruce, go first here. What'd you see today?
How could you not dance? Maryland did not have one of its better days. Until Alstead Henningsen turned around the faceoffs, they were getting swamped. But Connor Kelly, 8 points or 9 points, whatever it was. The key goal, Timmy Rotance, gave him the two-goal lead. Who put us up, DeMaio, or does that tie it?
Anthony DeMaio put us up by one.
Right.
And then Rotance put us up 11-9. Maryland holds on 11-10.
But the turnovers, what? This didn't look like a Maryland team to me. I mean, they literally, even when it was 12-10 and they had the ball, another turnover. They must have had 14 turnovers. You can't win like that.
Yeah, the game seemed sloppy all the way around. And when you look at Maryland, of course, it was uncharacteristic. But also from Rutgers, 0-for-6 for on the man up early, and they were also bumbling it around and turning it over nonstop, so the weather definitely had an effect on everybody on the field today.
Yeah, I just don't know why Maryland came out in a malaise. They've been on the road for what seems forever, and they go up 4-0, or I should say Connor Kelly went up 4-0.
Right. Terp Talk is brought to you by Viner Four Gates Consulting. You could reach us at 301-251-2900, or on the web at www.vinerforgates.com.
But to me, the big story about this win today, to me, is the emergence of Bubba Fairman. He was fantastic. When this game was getting out of hand, it was Bubba Fairman who scored two times in the third
scored
period.
Scored the seventh goal to tie it and the eighth goal to tie it.
Right. When things were looking, well, they were looking bad.
Yeah.
There's no doubt about it. And I'll let you assess Danny Morris today.
Well, it's kind of hard to do because first few goals for Rutgers seemed to be turnovers when he was running back to the cage with the defenseman. A few he was out of position, but other than that, he's fantastic as always. Made the stops that you need to make for Maryland to win the game.
He's good when it rains.
He's good all the time.
Yeah, he's really good when it rains,
all the time,
too.
But this was not a game that you would watch and after it's over saying, this is another championship team. They got a lot to work on.
But look, it was number seven, Rutgers. Number one, Maryland.
Right.
Did not look like a top 10 matchup.
No, but the weather didn't help. But I have to tell you that, you know, when a good team finds a way to win, there's no doubt. And when we were losing, when the Terps were losing, it was in, although you were pretty confident the whole time.
Yeah, we have just better talent.
Right. It just didn't look like they were going to win. But give them credit. They did it when they had to. They made the plays. They're now 3-0 in the Big Ten. Just about guarantees you a spot in the playoffs.
Sure. You got Ohio
weird
State.
Weird things can happen.
Yeah.
Ohio State next week and
right.
then at Hopkins.
Well, this might be one of the times I'm really interested to hear what Coach Tillman has to say about this.
Oh, he's going to be upset.
As you said, it was uncharacteristic, and it's just interesting to see how now they'll react to this and move forward past it. Is it one where you throw out the tape even though you won, or do you look at this and say this is what we do wrong?
He's going to say we have to button a lot of things up because Bryce Young, I've never seen, in 4 years, I've never seen him make a mistake like that when he threw the ball to the on the clear to the other team.
He hit him right at the 50. Right. He was open.
Right. And
pretty much ran in and scored.
If you're there's a reason did your lacrosse game when you watch a game like this, and I don't care if Maryland would have lost. Here's a number 8 team comes in. It's never beaten Maryland, had us on the ropes.
Mm-hmm.
And probably, like you said, if they convert early on those man-ups, Maryland gets blown out. All right? They lose time.
I mean, you got to say Maryland took those penalties. Those weren't questionable calls. Maryland really took those penalties.
No.
And that's where it started coming apart. But from a blazing 4-0 start, it was 5-1. Suddenly it was 5-5 at halftime. Rutgers gets a little bit of a lead, and then Maryland's talent wins out. And, we won. That's all that matters in the end.
Right. And we should mention that Megan Whittle set the all-time Maryland goal scoring record, which to me...
Is it 238?
I don't know the number, but to me it's unbelievable when you think back to Jen Adams and Taylor Cummings. Mm-hmm. I mean, Jen Adams was like... I can't even explain to you guys. You don't remember, but it was like forever. But to break that record, and she's kind of going under the radar a little bit. Now they FaceTime her and they... face guard her, and they do a lot of things, but let's give her ups today. Maryland just squashed Ohio State. Carolyn Steele had 5 goals. Jen Giles had 3.
Good to hear. Hey, and before we go down the press, it's too bad that Hop lost yesterday, because I was looking forward to the
undefeated teams. It could have been one against two or one against three.
But hey, we'll see what Coach Tillman has to say, and if we can get a player or two to come on camera after the game. Maryland wins it 11-10.
Next Sunday at 2 o'clock.
Sunday at 2. Ohio State's here. Good afternoon from the University of Maryland.
And what a good afternoon it is.